Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to set up Ingress Controller 1.9.0 on Kubernetes Cluster 1.19. This is my Kubernetes cluster environment. I have one master machine and two worker machine, worker 1 and worker 2. Before installing the Ingress Controller, let's understand how does it work with help of two architecture diagram. In my Kubernetes cluster, client will make a connection on the load balancer. In my environment, I have a external load balancer that support the ingress. Client will send the request to load balancer and load balancer will send the request to Kubernetes cluster. From the Kubernetes cluster, Ingress controller will manage the traffic or routing. It will send the request based on rules to the services. For example, a client is making a request on, so this is the client, and he is making a request on a browser. Browser will send the request to load balancer. Then load balancer will forward the traffic to Kubernetes cluster, and inside the Kubernetes cluster, Ingress will accept the request from load balancer, and Ingress will check the header of the request and identify what is a request, like what is a URL, what is a path. In this case, Ingress controller will identify this request for myapps.com and this is for blog path. Once Ingress identify the request type, it will check the rules. Based on the rules, it will send the traffic on respective services. Since this request for blog, it will forward the traffic to blog services, and from the blog services it is going to respective or attach ports. Similar way, if the client is requesting for myapps.com to store, request will go to load balancer. Load balancer send the traffic to Ingress controller. Ingress check the request type and check the rules. Then Ingress controller will send the traffic to required services. Then services will send the traffic on attach ports. That is a basic flow. How does Ingress controller work? So let's go ahead and install the Ingress controller on Kubernetes cluster environment. This is my Kubernetes master machine and all my three machines are up and ready. I am going to use a Kubernetes Ingress controller managed by Nginx. This is a repository and I am going to clone this repository. Go ahead and clone this repository. Go inside the deployment directory and check out the 1.9.0 version. Now we are going to start a deployment. First, we are going to create a namespace and service account. This manifest file is available in common folder. Okay, namespace and service account has been created. And then I am going to create a cluster role and bind this cluster role to this Nginx service account. It has been done. In this manifest, I am going to create a default Nginx ingress domain or reverse proxy for all unknown domain name. If there is a no rule for a domain in the Nginx rules, then Nginx control will throw 404 error instead of connection timeout error on the browser. Also, it is going to set up a TLS for the default domain. I am creating a config map for the Nginx controller. And I am going to create a ingress class resource. Your ingress controller will not be up if you don't install ingress class. Ingress class is mandatory for Kubernetes 1.18 onwards. Without ingress class, ingress controller will not be work on Kubernetes cluster that is running more than or equal to 1.18 version. No worried about the warning, it is just warning. Once we set up all the required parameters, domains and all settings, now we are going to set up a real ingress controller. You can set up the ingress controller in different mode. I am going to set up ingress in a daemon set. It means that at least one pod of ingress controller will run on each Kubernetes worker machine to handle the ingress related request. Let's go ahead and install it. It has been completed. Let's verify our ingress controller setup. Let's pull down the name server list. Yes, a separate name server is created for Nginx. Yes, two ports are running for the ingress controller. Let's look at any events or warning on both the ports. Started successfully. No warning, no error. Let's look at the events for the second pod. Everything looks okay. Let's verify that if Nginx controller is handling request of worker machine node 1 and node 2. This is the IP address of worker machine 1. If I browse the worker machine IP address, yes, look at here. Requests are handled by the Nginx controller. Since there is no rule for domain or IP address in rules, hence it is throwing 404 not found. It is accepted. Let's verify the second node. Yes, in the second node also, Nginx controller is handling the request successfully. Let's take an example of a application that has a host name. I am taking this example. In this deployment manifest file, I am using the ingress service and I have created a rule for the host name of the domain hotel.example.com and I set up the path for the root of the domain like this. So any requests are coming for hotel.com from the load balancer, Nginx will accept the request and look at the rules for this domain. According to this rule, any requests are coming on this host name and path going to hotel.svc service, and this is the hotel svc service that is listening on port 80. One more important point, if your Kubernetes cluster version is equal to or more than 1.18, then you have to define ingress class name. If you are using a Kubernetes ingress from Nginx, then Nginx is a default ingress class name. Go ahead and deploy this file on your cluster. Let's go ahead and deploy this manifest file. Yes, it has been deployed. Let's verify. My deployment created a separate namespace called Hotel. Okay, two ports are running for my deployment on node 1 and node 2. Let's check the ingress services for the my deployment, and you can see here one of the ingress services created for my deployment. Let's describe this ingress services for the more information. This is the rule for my ingress controller. This is the host name. This is the path, and this is the backend service. Everything looks okay. Let's try to access our application with the host name. I can access my hotel application from any of the worker node since I am not using a professional DNS service. So for testing, I am creating or updating the local etc host file. This is the host name for my application, and this is the IP address of one of the my worker machine. Let's go ahead and save it. Now let's try to access the application. Yes, look at here, the requests are getting served from 194 port. If I refresh again, you can see here, second time the another port serve our request. It is getting changed every time. This is the complete step-by-step example how to set up a latest version of ingress controller on latest version of Kubernetes cluster. That's all in this video. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. Goodbye.